This is video 2 in the series of the 2 videos for our quick reports. So in the first video, I took you how to run a quick report in our customers module. Now I'm going to take you through the same report, but a little bit more advanced into our journal module. So let's start by clicking on the journal icon. And then up on our toolbar, we need to click on all. Now we click on the report button on our toolbar, just like we did in the first video. And again, we're presented with a blank report, and we need to actually generate this with adding in the fields that we want to. So for this example, we're just going to go quickly through clicking on the fields that we want, dragging and dropping them up. So let's do our register date and our account ID. We're going to do debit and credit. And let's put in here our fees as well. Let's put in our local fees. And then let's put in the local currency as well. So we'll do that for debit and credit. Just like in the previous video, you'll notice the red line. So we need to adjust to fit everything in. So let's just select and make the font just a little bit smaller so we can fit everything in. And we can also adjust the size of the width of the columns as well as we see fit. But let's get right into, we're going to actually put in a couple of lines of sorting. So we're going to sort some of this data. We're first going to, let's sort it by our date. So again, we just click on the arrow across, or we can drag and drop. So we can also sort by our account ID, and drag and drop as well. So now that we've done that, we can now set some more parameters into our report. So let's play around with a little bit of the formatting first. So again, we've made our font size, and now we can actually add a little bit of formatting here. We can make the titles bold and centered. Let's change a little bit of the wording in our titles as well. Instead of debit, we can now write purchased. And credit can be sold. So let's do some sums. So let's say we want to have some subtotals of our purchases and us and what we've sold as well. So we can do that by just clicking on the cell we want to put it in, and going up to our toolbar, we can click on the sum button. Clicking again right here, let's do another sum here. So what we've done is wherever the account ID changes, we're going to do a subtotal. So we're going to have a subtotal of each account ID. Now for our local currency, we can do a sum in our date changed column, so that when every time the date changes, a different day, we can have a total of all the different accounts in that date. So let's click on the sum button again, and in this cell as well. You can also write next to the sums as well so that we can say actually what this is. So for this example, we can put total for the day, and that's in US dollars. And then right here, if we click into this cell, we can say that this is our subtotal for account. We can also add in different formulas as well. We can also do a count. So if we want to know exactly how many transactions we've done that day, so at the end of that date range, we can actually put in a sum in here as well. So we can click on the cell we want to use, and instead of a sum, we actually want to make it a count. So we've got count up here. And again, we can write next to it what we want that to actually state. So number of transactions. And that will be on there. So we've also got our grand total line as well. So we can actually have a sum in there as well. Makes sense. And obviously we can call that grand total. Now we can also play around with the colors and also the borders. So we can actually make it a little bit more functional for us. So let's say that we want our subtotals to come up in a different color. So you can select the palette tool up here, and you can choose your color that you want to do that in. And let's do the same for our total. let's just choose a different color right here. And then we can play around with the borders as well. So let's say we want to do the whole table. So we can select it by clicking on this open top left cell, right click, and scroll down to borders. Once in here, we can play around with what kind of borders we want to do. So let's just put in our borders right there. That gives us our basic borders, so we just say OK. And then let's say that we actually want our subtitle account, right click on borders. We want to put in a darker line just to differentiate between the two different accounts. And then we could do the same right here for our dates as well, so that it gives a good solid line in between our dates. So let's run this and see what it looks like. We can do that again like I showed you in the first video. Click on File and Print Preview. We've obviously got quite a few more results, so it's actually generating more than just one page like in my previous video. And here we go. So we have our titles and our columns, they're bold, centered. Then we have all of our information below. We've got the dates and our accounts. We've got our sub account, subtotal for our accounts. Then we have our number of transactions and the count, and then our total day in our local currency. So let's go back into that report, and we can just change a few other things too. We can play around even more with the formatting. So let's say in our detail, we actually want to change the formatting of how the currency is coming through. So if we right click once we're in that cell and go to format, we can then play around with what that currency format looks like. So in this example, we're going to just select this one so that the currency, if it's zero, it will actually come up as blank. And we can do that or change different ones for each one going on, going forth. And so on and so forth. We can also eliminate the duplicates of the account IDs and the date ranges, so we don't need to see every single date that is the same and every single account ID that's the same multiple times on your report. You can do that by selecting the column header, right click, and then you'll see repeated values has been checked. So let's uncheck that. Let's do the same for the date, so click on the column header, right click, and uncheck repeated values. Let's save this report so that we can use it again and again, because what we can do here is save the actual template that we've created, not the information that's generated from the report. So on your toolbar we do have the save button and save as, so you can either click here or we can go to File, Save As, and you can save this report wherever that you need to. So let's just say journal end of day report 1. We're going to save it to our desktop and click save. Now let's generate the report. So we're going to go to our print preview and just see what the report now looks like now that we've made those slight changes. And you'll see now instead of multiple lines of cash USD, we only have one. And instead of multiple lines of this same date, we only have one. We've got our formatting so that there was $0 sold in these columns, so now it's blank. And you'll see that the old formatting is applied over here where we haven't done anything with that formatting, so we've got the zeros. And then we have our bolded lines dividing out each subtotal and total. And we also have our grand total right at the end of the report. Okay, let's go back into our quick report. So once we have used this quick report, we can make some edits to it and actually save, and we can name it as different reports, or we can just keep saving to modify and change this report. Now I'm going to take you out of here and I'm going to show you one more thing that we can do. So when we were running these quick reports, we were running them on based on all of the information that was here on our main screen because we clicked all on our toolbar. You can actually run queries first and then run your reports on those queries. So let's just do that really quickly. So down at the bottom, from a previous video, I showed you how to do audit queries. If we click right here, we can just quickly do a query. Let's do one on just all of our cash transactions. Let's do all of our buys and all of our sells. We can perform this query, and then we can close. So now on our main screen, we've got all of our cash transactions. So it's not the same information as we just ran a report on. Now we can go back onto our toolbar and click on Report, and we can bring up our query, our report that we just saved. So we can go to File and Open, and we can find the report that we just saved. So it was Journal Report 1, and you'll see that is exactly what we just did. And then we can run that report. So let's do Print Preview. And now we're running this quick report based on the new information that we just did from our audit query. So the results are a lot smaller because we've only done our cash purchases and sells. Okay, and so that is how you do a quick report in your journal register. It's how you save it as a template, reuse it, based on all information or on quick audit queries that you have done, so you can modify the information before you run the quick report on it, showing you the formatting that you can do, the formulas that you can do. You can change the titles. We can put in the fields that we wish to do, and that we can order those in a certain way.